So first of all, I want to give you a quick scenario here. So let's zoom out, and you can see at the top of the screen here, we have the Constrain Delay Compensation tool. And what I'm going to do, give you an example of that. Before we move on to the Project Logical Editor magic that I'm going to do, I just want to quickly show you what CDC does, because it's super handy. So let us say that you are recording on this audio channel here. Right, it's selected. And you can see that I've got an instance of Sooth 2 here in the track. And the latency, because that's quite a high latency plugin, and of course this could apply to chains of plugins, whatever, you can see that the latency is quite high. And that would make it very, very difficult if I'm using monitoring through Cubase, which I do. It would make it very difficult to actually record in real time, right? So this is where the CDC button comes in. And what you can do is you can set in preferences, you can set an amount of time in milliseconds, and anything above that that appears in the latency, CDC will disable it. So if I click this, and let's go back to the mixer, and then make sure that the track is in record ready mode, you'll see that that has now become disabled. It needs to be in record ready mode, obviously, because the whole point of this is for live recording. So we're in record ready mode, and you'll see that now that has been completely disabled, along with everything else that brings any channel above your chosen amount, which in my case is 1.5 milliseconds. Fantastic. And then when you're finished, you go back up to this tiny little button up here, or if you've got a key command, and you switch it off and everything comes back. So you've seen how CDC works. My issue with this is a little tiny button up over in the corner there, right? Up there somewhere. Hang on. Let me, yeah, up there. And when you're in the heat of the moment, yeah, it's super, super useful because, you know, like I've just showed you, that in one click of that and any plugins that are interfering with latency gives you back super low latency and off you go. Of course, there are other ways to monitor so that you don't get any latency at all. But if you're monitoring through the program like I do and like a lot of people do, this is the tool for you. However, the problem is that it's such a tiny little button and there's no indication that that has happened, right? So if you're in the heat of the moment, you'll quite often carry on and you haven't got the mixer open, so you can't see that happening. You've just got this little button up here. You know what I'm getting at, right? What I'm going to say is quite simple. You forget to turn it back off again. So you forget to turn it off. You've adjusted to the way things sound, although it can be quite drastic at times, depending on what plugins are being disabled. But for the, in this case, for example, let's say that was a vocal and we had Sooth 2 on it. The effects of Sooth 2 can be quite subtle, right? So we've disabled it and we've carried on, and then we'll start mixing and then, you know, we'll do whatever we're going to do. And then, oh, you'll suddenly realise the drums aren't sounding quite right. And you'll go and you'll look and you'll realise that CDC is actually still on and all the plugins on the drum channel have been disabled, or one or two of the higher latency ones have been disabled. Not only that, it also affects the mixdown. So if you do an export with CDC on, those plugins will be disabled in your export. So, you know. So it's one of those things. It's a super, super useful tool, but there's no clear indication that it's switched on. So I wrote myself a little PLE thing to get around that, which I'd like to show you right now. First of all, we're going to turn it off. So let's hopefully bring back the PLE. And I'm going to load up my little preset, which is called CDC Warning. So I'm not going to show you exactly what this consists of just yet. Let me just show you the effect of it. So at the moment, you can see, let's zoom out of the screen, you can see that the CDC is off. And if I hit my key command to turn the CDC on, you'll see I get a track here that appears out of nowhere saying CDC on. And this track goes all along the project, right? And obviously it's a track, it's actually a dummy MIDI track, so you can make it, you know, however large or not you want it to be. You can see that CDC is on at the moment, and you'll see that Soother's disabled. If we go and hit my key command again, the track disappears, CDC is now off, and everything is back to normal. So how does that work? Well, let's bring up the track first. Okay, so the first thing you need to do is make a track called CDC on, exclamation mark, if you want. It's up to you, what you name it, whatever you like. Make it whatever color you like. And in fact, you can duplicate that as long as it's named the same. So we can put another one maybe down here, you know. How does it work? Well, we've got track that's named CDC on. What you do then, make sure that CDC itself is off, and we then go and hide those two tracks, all right? So hide that track and the other one, like that. So they're now hidden. Basically, that is the normal state that the project would be in. You know, CDC is off, everything's normal, and you're not seeing anything. We then come back to our project logical editor. Property is set is selected. Container type is equal to a track, and the name is equal to CDC on. So that's the track that we just created, and then we hid it. All right. And what's it going to do? The track operation is going to hide the track, and it's a toggle. And at the same time as hiding that track, we're also going to toggle in the pre-process command here. In fact, it's not at the same time, it happens before this, but anyway, we're going to toggle CDC on or off, depending on which way around. And this is why I've done it this way around, so that you can see the track's disappeared. If I hit apply now, you'll see those two alarm tracks, which you can't miss, are now brought back into view, and the CDC is on. And of course, to take that a step further, Logitech G510 here, I mean C, and basically the key command that I've got set for CDC, I've got it on a button here, and all I have to do is press that, and voila. So that's pretty neat. I find that extremely useful. So while we're at it, let's just look at key commands. So you can see there, because that was the last action that was taken, you can see that we've already got Constrain Delay Compensation. There's no key command assigned to that. So what I've done, and we'll just get the text. So all the presets that I've made, all the factory presets, everything, exists under this menu of Process Project Logical Editor. So you can then assign, and I've done mine, Control-Alt-C, any key command to any of your presets. And that's really where the whole thing comes into its own, because then you don't need to bring up the, whoops, let's close that. You don't need to keep bringing up this dialogue. So even without that there, I now do this, one button, and I'm in the middle of recording and I want CDC on, and now I finish recording, I can see, oh yeah, look, there's what are those two great big orange tracks there? Ah, yes, turn it back off again. Soothe comes back on, all the other plugins come back on, and off we go. Bob's your uncle.